Hello students of standard 9th. Welcome to DAV Mall Public School. I am your English teacher Jagruti Mishra. Let's begin our today's online session of English. Dear students, today we will revise the lesson from your Beehive book, Sound of Music, Part 1.
God may have taken her hearing, but He has given her back something extraordinary. What we hear, she feels far more deeply than any of us. That is why she expresses music so beautifully. Now let us study in detail Sound of Music, Part 1, about Evelyn Gleeny. This chapter tells about the life story of a Scottish girl named Evelyn Gleeny. When she was 8 years old, it was noticed for the first time that she had lost her hearing capacity to some extent. She managed to conceal it from her friends and teachers in the school. But when she was 11, the case of her deals got confirmed. She had lost her hearing capacity totally. It happened as a result of gradual nerve damage. Everything had turned black for her. But she did not give up to it. She was determined to lead a normal life. She learned music. A famous percussionist, Ron Fox, helped her a lot in learning of music. He encouraged her and told her not to hear music through her ears but through some other way. She practiced hard and got success in listening to music through other organs of her body. She had learned to open her mind and body, sounds and vibrations. She never looked behind from that point onwards. She toured the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra. At the age of 16, she decided to make music her life. She gave an audition for Royal Academy of Music. She scored one of the highest marks in the history of academy. She has got a mastery of some thousands instruments of music. She could listen and understand even the minute point. It seemed impossible that a deaf person like her can respond to the things so fluently. She spoke flawlessly with a Scottish lisp. She says that music pours in through her every part of her body. It tingles in the skin, her cheekbones, and even her hair. When she plays the xylophone, she can listen to its music through the fingertips. By leaning against the drums, she can listen to the echoes in her heart. She performs barefooted on a wooden platform so that music may reach to her heart through her feet and legs. In 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award. She calls her a workaholic. Apart from the regular concerts, she gives free performances in prisons and in hospitals. She also gives high priority to the classes for young musicians. She is a shining inspiration for deaf children. In this lesson, it gives an inspiration to those who are physically handicapped. The author has shown how handicapped persons are to face trouble and difficulties in their life. Most of them do compromise with their destiny. They accept their handicapped life and take to begging or some other lawless activities. But some persons, being handicapped, do not give up. They struggle hard. They fight it hard and rise themselves to a high position in life. To them, handicapped life is not a curse but a boon. A small girl like Evelyn Gleeny gets her hearing capacity totally killed, but she does not give it to it. She struggles hard and learns the music. She becomes the most sensational music star in the world she becomes a figure of inspiration for disabled people. Hope students, you have understood this lesson.
Dear students, based on today's revision, here are some questions for you. Have a nice day. Thank you.